Carson Arthur, a celebrity HGTV gardener, is here today to dispel some myths we have in the garden.
We're setting the record straight today, that's for
good.
Sure. All right, well, let's have a little fun. It's bright and sunny outside.
Yes.
Should you water your grass and plants on a hot, sunny day like today?
Now, I think like my grandpa would say no because it's a waste of water because it's just going to evaporate. So wait till it's cooler.
Good answer.
Would he be right?
The truth is, people used to think, and you can see on this plant, these little water droplets would actually act as magnifying glasses and burn the grass. But if you've ever been down south, it rains and then you get sun and the plants are all in one piece still.
Okay.
The truth is, yes, water your plants and grass when they need it, and if it's hot and sunny, do it. But you're right, your grandfather would have been right. The oscillating sprinklers, these ones, don't use those because you evaporate more water than you actually get to the plants.
Right.
Stay away from those.
Keep it closer to the ground.
Exactly.
Okay.
Next
soaker
one.
Soaker hose.
Soaker hose is perfect. Are chemicals, pesticides and insecticides that are organic, more or less toxic than the non-organic variety?
I think most people would say less.
Wrong. They're exactly the same.
Nice.
In fact, all the chemicals that are in this one, which aren't in this one, are replaced by something made by chrysanthemums. Now, chrysanthemums is a very toxic plant.
I guess they have to be toxic to kill something. It just makes sense.
It's still very toxic and very harsh. People think they can go willy-nilly and just spray this everywhere because it's organic.
Yeah.
Not the case. Read the labels. It's very important. You can do some damage.
All right.
All right. Gas-powered tools, more or less environmentally friendly than battery?
Oh, I think less, based on the smell.
Well, we know gas-powered tools burn fossil fuels.
Yes.
Fossil fuels are bad. What we've also learned, though, in a lot of reports lately, is that batteries in the landfill can also be very toxic. However, there are tools out there, like these amazing Black & Decker ones, that have recycling programs.
Okay.
And you can recycle the batteries, which means the components that are in the battery are being reused after you're done with them.
So where do you take it?
That is a huge one. There's actually a 1-800 number.
Perfect.
You can call them directly and just get it replaced, which is fantastic.
Nice.
What's also really nice is these batteries are multi-purpose.
Oh,
so
that
the
is
battery
really nice.
Goes into different tools.
Okay.
So as soon as you get into that situation, you're doing a much better job because you're not just using one battery and then throwing it away when you're done.
Smart.
You can actually reuse it, repurpose it. Mm-hmm. And right now, if you want to be green, these are all on sale. It's Green Week,
nice.
So this is a good time to buy your eco tools.
Perfect.
All right, let's talk about something else. Let's have a little fun, because everybody always talks about eggs and beer.
I was going to say, did you bring some beer with you?
I brought beer and eggshells. Now, are beer and eggshells good in the garden for deterring slugs?
Yes.
No.
Well, the beer would attract them, wouldn't it?
The beer attracts neighbors,
but the
raw egg
chase them away.
Yeah. Everybody used to think that the shells around a plant would actually stop slugs from going and eating the plant.
Mm-hmm.
Completely false.
They just ate the shells too?
They just walk over the top, they don't even care. And the beer, yes, it attracts slugs, but what we found is that it actually brings in slugs from the yard, from your neighbor's yard. So, I mean, if you're going to throw
free beer.
That's
what beer does, it brings people together.
Exactly,
works
so it doesn't
slugs.
Do a thing.
Okay.
Another one that I love, should you put coffee grounds in your garden? Now, we talk a lot about coffee grounds.
I'm going with yes, for sure. Although I don't know if I ever knew the reason why.
Yep, no, you shouldn't do it.
Okay, I'm not going to bother learning
completely that. Completely false. Coffee grounds acidify the soil. In fact, you can make your soil very toxic by spreading coffee grounds. And because people just go crazy with it, thinking it's great, they're actually poisoning their plants.
So stop it.
Yeah, we got time for some more?
Yes.
All right, let's talk about clay versus plastic.
Yes.
Which of these pots is better for your plant?
I would say this. I would think the plastic would get too hot.
Well, you're wrong again.
I'm totally
guessing. You are striking out here. The clay pot actually is good for holding moisture.
Okay.
Unfortunately, what happens is when it gets wet, it sucks all the moisture away.
It holds it in itself, not in your plant.
Exactly. So it sucks all the moisture away from the roots of your plants, so your plants dry out a lot faster.
It kind of is common sense if you think about
it. Yeah, it's true. Plastic pots, perfect little ecosystem, and oftentimes they're either made of recycled materials or can be recycled. So this is a much better option. Got time for more?
Yes. Now, are you going golfing?
I love this one. This is my favorite. I've been golfing in Edmonton, so I know that there's a big golfing population here.
Yes.
Should you cut your grass wearing your golf shoes?
I think not. Well, they'll get super grass stained, for one.
You look fancy.
You look fancy.
People used to think that these little nubs would actually aerate the lawn. But they don't do a thing.
No.
No, no, no. In fact, you need pumps that are 3.5 to 4 inches.
Right.
Kind of like those.
Let's
show our shoes.
Woo! Right now.
She's aerating the lawn as we go. It's fantastic.
Just a little spot, though.
Yeah, so it's all good until your friends see you doing it, right?
Although you'd look super fancy mowing the lawn in these shoes.
Exactly.
Okay. And we have a giveaway. What are we giving away?
We're going to give away this power tool today.
Fantastic.
Isn't that amazing?
With a rechargeable battery,
with the rechargeable lithium battery. So this is the 36 volt, and this is as strong as if you plugged it into the wall.
There's my number. Okay, 486-9233 if you want to win. Out of town, 877-486-2376. Fantastic stuff. I wish I was right on more.
No,
next
it's okay.
Time. Thanks.